You want to start making music. You've got the beat in your head, maybe some words jotted down, and now you just have to learn the software. Luckily, Magix Music Maker 2020 is music production software that makes it very easy to start making music in your home studio. In this video, I'll be reviewing Magix Music Maker 2020, comparing the different versions. There's free, plus, and premium. And I'll also be doing some guitar recording into it using the free guitar amp sim that comes with Magix Music Maker. And I'll record some MIDI into it using my MIDI keyboard. So you can see just how easy it is to start making music with Magix Music Maker 2020. Welcome to Simple Green Tech. I'm Radio Zane, and on this channel, I do audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you unleash your creativity. So today we're looking at the all-new Magix Music Maker 2020, and it comes in three main versions. There's Magix Music Maker Free, Plus, and Premium, and those are the main editions that you can get. There's also some specialty editions like 80s edition, hip-hop, trap music, and those can be great to get you started in making those styles of music. I put a link to Magix's official website in the description below, so you can easily head over there, download the free version, or you can see if there's any offers or sales on the more premium editions. But right now, we're going to check out what's new in Magix Music Maker 2020. It looks like most of what's new is just really cosmetic differences, but that's pretty cool because these cosmetic differences can actually alter your workflow within the program, and they can allow you to quickly make music the way you want. So the first new thing that we'll look at is you can now customize your user interface by moving the different sections around to wherever works best for you. And you can see how this will help you with your personal workflow. And the second thing that's new is it has a slightly different look to it. It's a more modern, streamlined look. It is a subtle difference, but I find things like the look of the interface can really help with inspiration. So it's always welcome when a company tries to make things look clean and tidy. And the third new thing can really help with your workflow as they have redesigned the arranger area. This is the main section that you'll be working in to create your beats and your music. And you can now drag a loop underneath an existing track and it will create a new track for that loop. The track header now includes volume control, and you can resize tracks to make them minimized or larger. These are some great added features. If you've used previous versions of Magix Music Maker, you'll notice that in this new 2020 version, the start dialog box has changed a bit. This is where you can access tutorials, videos, demo projects, previously created projects, and you can launch a new project from here. They've also improved their MIDI editing and recording functions, allowing you to quickly record, then edit your music with ease. Now, all of those new features that I just mentioned are available in the free, plus, and premium versions. There are some new features that are available just to premium users, and we'll look at those now. First up, Magix Music Maker 2020 premium users get the two core effects bundles, which include 5 mastering effects and 3 delay effects. Another great new feature for premium users is you actually get a free copy of SoundForge Audio Studio 12. And this is a great piece of recording and wave editing software. So we've quickly looked at what's new in Magix Music Maker 2020. Now let's look at some of the core features that make Magix Music Maker a great program. In all three versions, it's installed with 453 sounds and loops that are available to you right away. With Magix Music Maker Free, you can download an additional 4 sound pools. All you have to do is go over to Store in the Media Pool area here. And then right here, you want to make sure it says Sound Pool. So if it doesn't, you click on Sound Pools. And then down here where it says Name, you want to click and change that to Price Ascending. You can now see 4 free sound pools here. And if you download all 4 of these, you're going to be adding over 1,000 loops and sounds. With the Plus and Premium versions, you can download a lot more for free, and you're free to select from a lot more. With the free version, you get 3 basic instruments. You get the Concert Grand, you get Revolta, and you get Vita. With the Plus version, you get to freely select 3 more instruments from the store, and with the Premium version, you can select 6 more from the store. Also with the Premium Edition, you get Isotope Ozone Elements 8, which is a great VST plugin that really can help your tracks sound great. This plugin alone goes for around $99 on its own. Now I'm going to connect my MIDI keyboard here. It's the M-Audio KEYSTATION 32. It's a mini keyboard, very easy to connect, and I'm going to show you how to do some MIDI recording. So I'm going to quickly drag over a drum loop from the media pool area here. I'm going to drop it into our track. So now I have a quick drum beat to work with. So I'm actually going to hold down Control on my computer keyboard and then click and drag to create another one. And that way I'm going to loop it into a few more bars here. And I'm going to bring in an instrument. I'm going to bring in the Revolta instrument. This comes free with all 3 versions of Magix Music Maker. And you can see when I bring it in, it creates a demo MIDI clip. I'm just going to delete that. You can listen to it if you want, but I'm going to be creating a new one when I record my keyboard into here. You want to make sure this says MIDI record right here. And I'm going to record a quick bass line into here. I'm going to turn on my metronome by clicking right here. And we're going to hit the record button. Okay, so now I have my bass line here and I want to edit it a bit. So if you just double click on the MIDI clip, you're going to bring up the MIDI editor here. So I'm going to want to move some of these here. And once you have everything lined up, you can just click the X up there and you can see we now have our bass line here. And we can do the same thing that we did with the audio track up here. We can press Control on the computer keyboard, click and drag, and you've created a duplicate that you can move wherever you want. So my basic little bass line is nice and tidy now. And now I want to record my guitar in using the free guitar amp sim that's included with all versions of Magix Music Maker. And it's called Vandal Bass and Guitar SE. So I'm going to go to track 3 here. Then I'm going to click on Effects. And I want to go to Audio Effects Track Rack. So what I want to do is go down to the plus sign, go to Magix Plugins, and click on Vandal SE. And here's our free guitar amp sim plugin. You can see it has some presets in there. I'm not going to be too fussy here, so let me just select one. I now have a quick guitar recording, bass line, and drum beat, and it really didn't take me much time at all. I could loop these over and over and create another section if I really wanted to, and it would be just as easy. There are some other great tools in Magix Music Maker. I'll get into those in other videos. Of course, you don't have to record any audio to make music in Magix Music Maker. It includes well over 1,000 loops and sounds in the sound pools that are even included with the free version. Let me know in the comments below if you do download Magix Music Maker and you're able to create some music with it. Click this video up here to see my top 5 free DAW picks, and click this one down here to see what YouTube recommends you watch next. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos like this. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Radio Zane, and we'll talk soon.